For more than 250 days, Saeed Abedini has languished inside one of the most brutal prisons in the world.
Why is he being held? Because he exercised his rights of religious freedom, expression, and peaceful assembly.
Recently, his wife took her husband's case before the UN's Human Rights Council in Geneva.
I hope that my presence here today will put a face to those who suffer when a government does not uphold its obligation to protect these freedoms.
The 33-year-old Iranian-born U.S. citizen is sentenced to 8 years in prison for his Christian faith, and while in prison, has endured torture.
On at least two known occasions, Iran's officials have physically tortured my husband. These instances of tortures have caused my husband to have symptoms of internal bleeding.
The White House on Monday said it was deeply concerned about Pastor Abedini's plight and promised to press for his release until he was back home with his family. The U.S. State Department also chimed in.
We condemn Iran's continued violation of the universal right of freedom of religion and call on the Iranian authorities to respect Mr. Abedini's human rights and release him. We will continue to pursue this in every way that we possibly can, through every channel that we possibly can.
But Abedini is not alone. Last month, Iranian authorities shut down the largest Persian language church and arrested its pastor. With less than 2 weeks to go before Iranians pick their next president, authorities are reportedly targeting individuals and groups deemed dangerous, including growing Christian churches. Just before ending her UN speech, Nagmeh said on Facebook that she wanted to use her appearance to plant the seeds of the gospel message before a global audience.
Iran has kept Saeed's imprisonment because Saeed believes in forgiveness of sin through Jesus Christ, and that whoever accepts this forgiveness of sin can be reconciled to the God of peace and love. This is the God of peace we're all searching for.